My first question for you is, what was something that your team did this year that you were really happy about, that you were really proud that they were able to do and did consistently?
Well, I think the thing that impressed me most about this group, because this was my first year with them, their first year with me, is that they had such a desire to win. I mean, the attitude's got to be there regardless of the ability level, and they had a real desire to win, and they proved from the beginning of the year to the end of the year that they wanted to just get better, and they did each game. So we were competitive. We were in the games. We ended up 8-6 in the district. Could have done much better if we'd have elevated our free throw percentage and turnovers ratio, but I was real pleased that these kids have such great attitudes.
And in a different direction, what was something that they did that did make you happy, but you would like to have seen more of it?
Well, I think the way we ran our offense, in the beginning, we were very impatient, taking shots way too early, not looking for the better shots. And as the season went on, we got much better at being patient, at running the offense, where all five girls know where the other ones are and so forth. And then our defense was much better. Our press got to the point where everybody was worried about our press. The coaches told me, when we play you, we've got to work against that press. So I thought the kids did a great job in both areas as the season went on.
Now, looking at where the team started the season to where the team finished this season, how would you grade their overall progress throughout the year?
Well, as far as their overall progress, I think they, when we started out, we played McLeod the first game, and they beat us handily. We made mistake after mistake. And the very next game, they showed that, hey, we want to win, and we lost to Wascom in overtime, but played a great game. And I think the two things that hurt us, of course, is turnovers. We had too many, and then free throw percentage was too low. But I think the overall rating I would give them would be an A+ as far as attitude, as far as effort, because they're the kind of kids you just enjoy being around because they want to win.
And which player would you give your season's MVP award to?
Well, I think it'd be hard to say because I had so many that contributed. I just have to name several, because Sarah Northey stepped up, did a great job for us at post. Lacey Lyles did a great job. They're both coming back. Kaylin Thompson is a great competitor and really good on defense. I'd almost have to take each one and just break it down to their assets, Candace Wise, only a sophomore, but started for us, did a great job. And we've got a newcomer coming up. There was only a freshman, Kylie Parker, that's probably as good as any freshman I've seen in a while. She was my sixth man, and we got some people like Lindsay Tidwell and Lauren Parker that are both sophomores. So we've got some kids that are really coming up, and it'd be hard to pick an MVP out of that group.
Who was the player then that, from the start of the season to the end of the season, player or players that made the greatest jump, made the greatest amount of improvement?
I'd have to say it would probably be Lauren Hyatt, our senior. Our point guard made a tremendous amount of improvement. In fact, she was picked unanimously by the coaches as All-District. And then Lacey Lyles improved greatly because she was also first-team All-District. They were both unanimous choices. So that means all seven of the other coaches thought a lot of their ability. And I thought they both improved so much, as did the other players. But I thought they brought their game to another level as the season, especially when we got into the district games.
What do you see for next season?
I think we're going to be right there in the mix. I would say one of the stronger teams will be White Oak because they have everybody back. Harmony lost a lot of people. So did Sabine, although Sabine had a strong bench. But I think Elysian Fields will be a team that will be in the mix, and we'll be there right there. This year we could have been – we carried Harmony to 3 overtimes before they beat us. So we were – we were able to play with these people. And if we can cut down on our turnovers and increase our free throw percentage by at least 10%, because we were just under 60% as a team, not only can we be in the mix, we can win the district.
I would like to honor and introduce a special group of talented young ladies, and they are our 2009 Lady Jackets senior basketball players. First up tonight, we got Miss Carolyn Boyette. She is the daughter of Sheila Boyette. Carolyn is a member of the Fellowship of Christian Athletes, where she's secretary. She's in the National Honor Society and is president of the Art Club. In addition, Carolyn is a student council member and a senior Girl Scout. Carolyn participates in both varsity volleyball and varsity basketball. After graduation, Carolyn plans to attend Stephen F. Austin State University. Next is Cheryl Boyette, daughter of Sheila Boyette and twin sister of Carolyn. A National Honor Society member, Cheryl is also in the top 10% of her class. She is senior class parliamentarian and a member of the FFA forestry team. Cheryl is co-drum major of the Jacket Pride Band. times. She played volleyball for 4 years, and this will be her fourth year to run track. She also ran cross country. Caitlin is a three-year one-act play participant and is a member of the youth group at New Hebron Baptist Church. She's the best trainer slash stat keeper the Lady Jackets have ever had. Caitlin hopes to attend either Texas A&M or Louisiana Tech and obtain a degree in chemical compounding. Please join me in congratulating our Lady Jacket seniors. Thank you.